looking at the camera because they always have to look down and away.
Good morning, everyone, and happy Easter. Welcome to St. Oliver's on this Easter Sunday, the resurrection of the Lord. This coming Saturday, April 6th, beginning at 7 p.m., the Perpetual Adoration Ministry will be hosting an all-night vigil for the parish. Please consider joining us for all or just a part of this night, as we continue to celebrate the resurrection of the Lord. Please see the bulletin for more details. Next Sunday, April 7th, is Divine Mercy Sunday. Join us for a special adoration at 3 p.m. here in the church. Altar server training will be offered on Saturday, April 13th at 10 a.m. or Monday, April 15th at 7 p.m. Meet in the church for either of these two sessions and learn how you can serve the Lord and our parish. Contact me, Lucas McHenry, if you plan to attend. Life Teen will be sponsoring a Catholic jewelry and gift fundraiser after all masses April 6th and 7th, April 14th, and April 20th and 21st. Get a gift for graduation, First Communion, or Mother's Day, and help raise funds for Life Teen. Look for tables in the Family Center lobby. Church offices will be closed on Easter Monday, April 1st. Thank you for your attention. Our presider this morning is our pastor, Father Syriac, assisted by Deacon Mike. Please rise and join us in singing.
Happy Easter. I like to see the church every Sunday like this, you know, every Sunday. It's a wonderful thing. We are so glad that you're here to celebrate this very special day in our faith. And so let's begin in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Today we gather in joy to celebrate the holiest and most wonderful of days, Easter Sunday. Jesus, who sacrificed his life on behalf of us all, has been raised from the dead. Alleluia. This is the day that gives meaning to Jesus' suffering and death, and in return to our own. Suffering and death are not the end. Jesus has led the way to his Father for all eternity. How appropriate that we gather today for the Eucharist. In the Eucharist, we give thanks to the Lord for the ultimate sacrifice he made for our own sins. In the Eucharist, we receive the body and blood, more closely uniting us with him, now and eternally. Let us celebrate the Eucharist on this blessed day as we are reborn in the Lord. Coming together once again, let us acknowledge that we are sinners in need of God's mercy and place ourselves in his presence.
Lord, you are the way to the Father. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Lord, you are the truth that brings joy to the world. Christe eleison. Life that renews the world. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who on this day through your only begotten Son have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may through the renewal brought by your Spirit rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him, all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us rejoice and be glad. Let us rejoice.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, if then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, your life, appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Christians, all their voices raise and offer Easter hymns of praise as on the paschal lamb they gaze. Oh, praise the Lamb! Christ's sinless lamb from heaven above has saved all sinners, sin removed, restored them to the Father's love. Oh, praise the Lamb!
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary, the mother of James and Salome, brought spices that they might go and anoint him. Very early, when the sun had risen, on the first day of the week, they came to the tomb. They were saying to one another, "Who will roll back the stone for us from the entrance of the tomb?" When they looked up, they saw that the stone had been rolled back. It was very large. On entering the tomb, they saw a young man sitting on the right side, clothed in a white robe, and they were utterly amazed. He said to them, "Do not be amazed. You are seeking Jesus of Nazareth, the crucified. He has been raised. He is not here. Behold the place where they laid him. But go and tell his disciples and Peter, he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him as he told you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Christ is risen. Alleluia, alleluia. Cristo ha resucitado. Alleluia, alleluia. A little weak, you know, so. Alleluia, alleluia. Ah, there you go. That's good, yeah. Two confirmed bachelors were sitting and talking about cooking. One said that he had a fancy cookbook, but never did much with it. When asked why by the other, he replied, "Because every recipe started the same way. Take a clean dish and." Are you ready for a new life, a fresh start, a clean slate, a clean dish? It's not that easy as we think, because life presents us with a lot of struggles. In one of the National Catholic Youth Conference events, I met Sister Miriam Headland. She's a religious sister, and her story was a remarkable story of conversion, redemption, and, say, resurrection. Because she was a young woman with a lot of dreams in her life. She wanted to be an athlete. Her real goal was to become a sports news specialist. And that was the career, and she was very ambitious about that. But there were so many things that was preventing her from reaching the heights of her career. And she tells her story so remarkably well in her books. And she says, you know, she sought love in the wrong places instead of finding love in Christ. And she was a party girl, and she was, of course, she was adopted, and she was, from early on in her life, she was battling alcoholism and also trying to recover from a childhood sexual abuse. There were so many things, so many strikes against her, and she had a real hard time. How do you get out of that addiction, that problem in her life? She didn't know where to turn to or whom to turn to. You know, this was the same kind of predicament that the women, Mary Magdalene and mother of James and Salome, who went to the tomb. They had one anxiety in her mind: who will roll back the stone for us from the entrance to the tomb? Who will roll back the, you know? This was the same thing that Sister Miriam was facing in her life. Who will remove the obstacle, this heavy stone from her life so that she can be liberated? You know, because Satan doesn't want you to be liberated from your sin and your darkness, your abandonment, your rejection. He doesn't want that. He doesn't want joy. He doesn't want to see you happy in life. So she was kind of locked into her own tomb for sure. And this is where these women were surprised that the stone was already rolled away. Just as we see that Diane Kretzer and Patty, Diane Lux and Patty Kretzer, they have made this beautiful, imagery right there of the tomb of Jesus, where you see that the stone is rolled away. In other words, there is someone who has worked hard at it. It is the hand of God. It is the hand of God. The God who has seen the devastation, God who has seen the darkness, God who has seen the loneliness and the abandonment of people, he comes to rescue us from the tombs of our own misery. And Jesus embraced all that is unbecoming of us, all that is devastating in us, all that is weak in us. He embraced all of that. Embraced the cross and died on the cross, and then eventually entered into hell, the Sheols, into the darkness of the tomb. But that tomb was finally opened by the hand of God. And that hand of God is available. That hand of God is always at work in our life. And that's what we need to see in our own life. In his Easter message, Pope Francis remarked, that stone marked the end of Jesus' story, now buried in the night of death. He, the life that came into the world, had been killed. He who proclaimed the merciful love of the Father had met with no mercy. He who relieved the sinners of the burden of their condemnation had been condemned to the cross. The Prince of Peace, who freed a woman caught in adultery from a vicious stoning, now lay buried behind a great stone. That stone, an overwhelming obstacle, symbolized what the women felt in their hearts on that first day of the week in the morning. It represented the end of their hopes, their dreams, now dashed by the obscure and sorrowful mystery that put an end to their dreams. My dear brothers and sisters, it can also be that way with us, just as Sister Miriam Hedlund had realized in her own life. There are times when we may feel that a great stone blocks the door of our hearts, stifling life, extinguishing hope, imprisoning us in the tomb of our fears and regrets, and standing in the way of joy and hope. We encounter such tombstones on our own journey through life in all the experiences and situations that rob us of enthusiasm and of the strength to persevere. We encounter them at times of sorrow, in the emptiness left by the death of our loved ones. We encounter them in the failures or fears that hold us back from accomplishing the good we mean to do. When we experience these disappointments, do we also have the sensation that all these dreams are doomed to failure? That we too should ask ourselves in anguish, who will roll away the stone from the tomb? Yet the same women who bore this darkness in their hearts tell us something quite extraordinary. When they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had already been rolled back. Satan might be asleep, but God is always awake. His hand is always at work. This is the Pasch of Christ, the revelation of God's power, the victory of life over death, the triumph of light over darkness. The rebirth of hope amid the ruins of failure. It is the Lord. It is the God of the impossible who rolled away the stone forever. Even now he opens our hearts so that hope may be born ever anew. We too then should look up to him. Brothers and sisters, Jesus is our path. He's the one who brings us from darkness into the light, who is bound to us forever, who rescues us from the abyss of sin and death, and draws us into the radiant realm of forgiveness and eternal life. Let us look up to him. You know, let us welcome Jesus, the God of life, into our own lives. And today, once again, say yes to him. Then no stone will block the way to our hearts. No tomb will suppress the joy of life. No failure will doom us to despair. Let us lift our eyes to him and ask that the power of his resurrection may roll away the heavy stones that weigh down our souls. Let us lift our eyes to him, the risen Lord, and press forward in the certainty that against the obscure backdrop of our failed hopes and our deaths, the eternal life that he came to bring is even now present in our midst. That's what Sister Miriam Headland eventually came to experience. She learned to look up to God, because on her own she couldn't do it, but with the hand of God upon her, anything is possible. Now she, just like the women that we see in the gospel, she is running, she is going, she is on a mission, announcing the good news of God's forgiveness, God's redemption, God's saving act in her own life. And that's the good news that we must tell today through our life. And we must live just as people who believe in the resurrection. If you believe in the resurrection, nothing should disappoint you. Even if there is a disappointment, even if there is despair, there is always a way out, because the hand of God is upon us. The hand that comes to rescue us. This Paschal candle is the symbol of Christ. Christ, who is the light, will dispel any kind of darkness that we experience in our life and bring us a hope, because this is the candle of hope, a hope that will regenerate or rekindle the fire that is within us, the fire of God's love, fire of God's continued care for each and every one of us, the fire of his forgiveness that will lead us into better place, to better human beings, better families, better community. So Easter is about going. It's about rising, it's about running, pouring, anointing, and sprinkling with the holy water, and affirming and rejoicing. Easter is hearing, it is hearing once more the astonishing news that awakened the hearts of the women at the tomb. He is risen. Easter is proclaiming. It is proclaiming the good news that our Savior lives. It is telling the story of what God has accomplished in and through us. Easter is about telling stories of our own redemption, story of being in hell and back to a new life. Jesus, God, makes all things possible. Easter is about receiving the body and blood of Christ, and nourished by that body and blood of Christ, we are ready to go out into the world to tell the good news that Christ is risen. The question is, are you ready for the run? Are you? I can't run anymore, huh? No. But we can always do better. We can always improve in our life. Christ gives us the hope. Christ gives us the energy. Christ is the source of our salvation. He is the Redeemer. He is the Savior. He's the light of our life. And let this light come into our life so that we can once again say, Alleluia!
Alleluia!
Alleluia! Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism, by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God?
I do.
Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you?
I do.
Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin? Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
Amen.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
Amen.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen. On this glorious day, we look to the one with the power to raise the dead, asking for God's kindness and mercy upon all those in need.
For the whole church, reborn in the risen Lord, that we may continually bear witness to the effect of the resurrection in our lives, giving us and the world joy, hope, and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the resurrection of the Lord may bring comfort to those who suffer, hope to those in despair, and new life to all those who are dying. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the risen Lord may move the hearts of all those who are in conflict with one another, whether in wars between nations or grudges between neighbors, bringing peace and reconciliation among all God's children. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the newest members of the church, especially those who were baptized and confirmed at the Easter Vigil, that the good work the Lord has begun in them may continue to bear fruit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That more men and women will joyfully answer the call of the Lord to proclaim his life, death, and resurrection as priests and religious brothers and sisters. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the healing of those listed in our book of prayer for the sick, may God, in his infinite mercy, heal them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died recently, the innocent victims of abortion, all those listed in our book of the deceased, may they experience eternal peace in the kingdom of God, and especially in celebration of the wedding anniversary of Christian and Bethany Corvos, and in memory of Carmen Corvos, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of life and love, you raised your Son from the grave, giving us hope and meaning our lives to save. Grant that the new life you promised may raise us up as we raise our prayers to you through your Son, Jesus Christ, our risen Lord.
Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace,
the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
You may all be seated. The second collection this weekend is for sharing our faith, securing our future. Funds donated at this collection will benefit the various religious education programs we have here at St. Oliver's. We thank you for your continued support of our parish through your generous contributions.
Tabernacle.
dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day, above all, to praise you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people, exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Indeed, holy, and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, the perfect faith and charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Gregory, John, our Bishop, Joel, John, and Nettie's auxiliaries, with all bishops, priests, deacons, religious, and the entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters, inspiring us words and actions to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, with St. Oliver, our patron, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Gathering all our thoughts and our desires and our hopes and our dreams, we come to God the Father and pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come, at least spiritually, into my heart. As though you have already come, I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
King of kings, blessed Jesus, hand of mercy, giver of grace, I have come to sing glory, to lay my heart before you in this place. Sweet freedom, I surrender all I am to you. Sweet freedom, I surrender all I am to you. I was lost, and you found me. In the darkness, you were my light. When I fell down, you forgave me, lifted me up, and held me to your side. Sweet Redeemer, I surrender all I am to you. Sweet Redeemer,
shadows of the tomb, you call me, you roll away the stone. From the burden of my sin, you save me, you made my heart your home. Sweet Redeemer, I surrender.
Let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by the paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord. Amen. Well, I know a lot of you might be celebrating birthdays and anniversaries. We thank you for your presence, and may God continue to bless you and your families. I continue to invite you to please come and join us every Sunday if you can. Don't come for the fiery homilies of Deacon Mike or me, but you come for the bread of life. Come for Jesus. Come for to be nourished by the body and blood of Christ. That will give you hope, and that will give you a new life. You know, that's why we come. And I promise you, we will have a wonderful choir. You know, Lucas needs to get to the jacuzzi after all the hard work that he has done this whole weekend, you know. So yes, let's give him a big round of applause. Yes, yes, yes. I mean, they have done a phenomenal job this, Thursday, Friday, and last night, and today. Thank you, Lucas, and the whole choir and our production team there. We thank you for all your help and all the people who did the decorations, our art and environment team, and all the volunteers, all the ushers, Eucharistic ministers, lectors, and our wonderful altar boys and girls. We thank you for your dedication, your commitment, and to our deacons who are here. Thank you, and I hope to see you more and more every Sunday, you know. So I wish you, on behalf of the parish and on my own personal behalf, and on behalf of Father Ron and Father Bob and Father Peter and the two deacons and the staff, we wish you all a blessed Easter. And I also thank all my office staff. You know, they work really hard to make our community and our programs go really well. Thank you so much. And all those who support us in all our ministries, we thank you. May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity and in compassion defend you from every assault of sin.
Amen.
And may he who restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten endow you with the price of immortality.
Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal feast come with Christ's help and exulting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy.
Amen.
Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah. All right. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.